reaching heavenly abodes. He wants to know, he wants to reach the heavens. He wants to get hold of the truth. He wants to get hold of the best in the life. Okay. For that, he decided to take up certain sacrificial yagna. Okay. Yagna means some sort of a ritual, which is normally done by the great people to achieve some sort of life achievement goals. One of the yagnas was Vishwajit sacrifice, Vishwajit yagna. That means to conquer this physical world, to conquer the sorrow, to conquer whatever obstacles in the life, you know, he should not face. In such a state of life, he wanted to achieve. For that, he took up this yagna. Every yagna normally needs every person to sacrifice in donation to all the people, whatever he has got, to sacrifice his belongings. The best belongings we should donate. That was the customary and the conditions and the procedure of each and every ritual. So like this, the ritual which he intended to take up was Vishwajit ritual, yagna. Okay. Then he started doing it and he started donating all that whatever he has, whatever his belongings are. When such sort of donations are going on in that ritual, he had to donate a cow also. Normally, they donate cows to Brahmins in every ritual, whatever they do. So this Brahmin gave away one cow to a Brahmin in donation in the process of that ritual. But what happened? This cow was very old. It was not young. The rituals demand that healthy cows and good substances should be donated. Not spoiled one should not be given. While that is the order of the ritual, this sage has no better cow to offer, so he offered that. This was objected to by his son, called Nachiketa. He is a very wise, intelligent, honest, sincere boy. Like his father, he is an ardent educationist, a wise man. He objected to his father, "Oh father, this is not correct. The cow is ineligible to be donated. The result of the ritual will not be complete. The procedure does demand a healthy cow to be donated. So we should not follow the wrong procedure. We should not be found faulty." That was his argument. And with this, his father, finding lot of difficulty in executing the ritual and unable to fulfill all the conditions, you know, in 100% quality, somehow he had been with much difficulty executing that. So he got angry with that boy, you know, "You are finding fault with me, you are pointing out a mistake or whatever it is. You have unnecessarily raised the issue. Keep quiet, otherwise I will send you to Lord Yama." In a fit of anger, he cursed the boy. Then the ritual went on, continued further. In the meantime, what happened? This boy, he realized that the word coming from the mouth of my father should not go waste, should not go unimplemented. So he came to the father, but your father, I want to fulfill your vakshuddhi. It should be there. Whatever you say, it should happen. That is my earnest desire. So I am going to the Lord Yama. Kindly permit me. That's it. Then father felt very, very sad for that. He said, my dear child, actually in a fit of anger I told, just on the spur of the moment, I told something, but you don't take it seriously. I never meant that way. But he said, the boy said, it feels like you, a great personality on this earth planet, should not go with unimplemented talk, unimplemented word. Whatever you say should happen, my dear father. I am here to see that it is implemented. Don't worry about it. I will go to Lord Yama. As you say, it will be done. So saying this, he left for Amaloka. There, he went and saw at the palace of Yama and found Yama was not there. He was absent. And there was nobody to receive him. No hospitality for him. No welcome. Nothing. So he sat there only at the gates, at the entrance of the palace. For 1 day, 2 days, and 3 days. For all the 3 days, without any food, without any sleep, he spent on 3 days just waiting for Yama, Lord Yama, to come and see him. That's it. Then at the end of the 3rd day, Yama came and he saw this boy. Oh, he was also perturbed on seeing this boy. Oh, my dear Nachiketa, he knows everything. I am very sorry. You have been here for 3 days. I could not arrange any hospitality for you. I could not arrange to receive you at all. I am very sorry. You have been inconvenienced. Anyway, my dear Nachiketa, in return to the sort of inconvenience which is caused to you, in repentance, I would like to give you 3 boons, 3 gifts I want to give you. Just you ask anything, I will give. Come, let us go. So he received him, he took, and he gave all sorts of respect and reverence, all sorts of hospitality, and then asked the better friend, come on, ask whatever you want, I will give. I will look into your purpose. However, you ask the boons I want to give. Then he asked in the first one, Nachiketa asked, Lord Yama, my dear Lord Yama, I am very happy for your generosity of extending gifts to me. I wish in the first gift, I will request you to kindly help my father to have his aim fulfilled. As a result of the sacrificial yaga, that yagna he has done, kindly bless him with the good of that yagna. Whatever result supposed to be given to him, let him get. This is my first boon. Then he said, Lord Yama said, yes, done. He has the absolute shreyas. He will be getting all sorts of whatever his wish. Everything gets fulfilled. Okay, number 2, he said. Then he said, oh, my dear Lord Yama, many people are rotting in the earth planet. They are not aware of to have is a better kind of life, which lift them from sorrow and go towards heavenly abodes. Go towards heavens go towards, you know, a sort of sorrow-free life they want to have. Kindly let us know what is the secret for this, what is the way out for this, what is that we are supposed to conduct, supposed to do for this kind of happy life. What sort of actions you want us to take? What is the secret of this? So to his question, Yama answered. He gave several kinds of questions again, how to sacrifice. Giving is only the secret of getting. When you give, you will get it. So that is the reason in sacrifice. All that which is receiving is the fire, God of fire is there. The God of fire in Yaga and Yagnas, you know, all that it will be surrendered and give to the God of fire, it will completely absorb into that and transfer it to the respective gods. This is what Yaga is there. And Yaga is done through fire. Fire is called Havisu, and that Agni. So Agni Devata, Lord Fire, you have to understand. You have to ask him. The light, you have to ask. That is called a fire, that is a media of receiving all sacrifices and transferring it to the respective gods. That kind of fire, now I will give you the benefit of naming that fire with your name. So from today onwards, all great sages, all great kings, all great personalities on that planet desire to do all kinds of yagas with the fire named as Nachiketa. So every yaga, first submission, first gift is to Nachiketa only. So, my dear son, my dear boy, your name is befitted. Your name is world famous, is known across the globe. All yagnas will stipulate your name for yaga in the first and foremost procedural steps. First step is to donate to Nachiketa that fire. It has to go only with your name. So through this, the human kingdom will flourish. Everybody will come to know of this. Now, Nachiketa Agni, it goes on to the world for conduct of this kind of rituals, great works, good karmas. Rituals are called good karmas. So everyone will take up this sort of good karma and get sorrow-free lives. That's what he said. Then Nachiketa says, okay, my dear Lord, now I have third question, which is dearer to me. Actually, I was anchoring, craving only to know one truth that is bothering me right from my childhood. This was not answered by anyone so far. So I want you to clarify that. The question is that, what is this death? What is the secret of death? Why a man should die? After death, where these people are going? You kindly tell us why we should come across the death. How to escape that? Can we not escape? So these are all the doubts I have. So enlighten me, my dear Lord. That was the third question. Then Lord Yama said, oh, my dear boy, I am very surprised to hear such a question from you, child. This question is very, very, very secret. The answer cannot be revealed. Everywhere, nobody is permitted. Everyone is forbidden to discuss about this. Even in the heavenly abodes, we don't leak out what to say of the earth planet. We cannot reveal this to anyone, my dear boy. Except this, you ask anything, I am ready to concede. Kindly go on, ask something else. Don't insist on this. Upon that also, the boy did not leave his question. He said, my dear Lord, you are known for your keeping up your word, but I never thought that you would be going back in your own word. My dear Lord, I do not want anything. Do you think that I am not aware of the physical entities in the earth planet? Do you think that I will go after some sort of money and matter there? Do you think, am I such a boy? Did you consider me like that? No, I want only this sort of secret to be known. Kindly consider my request, he said. Then Yama, having given the word, he was in a critical position, neither to accept or reject. So he said, my dear friend, my dear boy, I would like to give you some information. I cannot reveal the truth. I cannot reveal the secret, but I can only guide you to understand what it is, to understand how it is, to understand how a man can escape. All those things you will be able to understand. In such a way, I will give you some sort of information which helps you in that direction. See? Very critically he wanted to answer. Neither he rejected nor he has accepted to give. So in that course of action he says, so my dear boy, the humanity on the earth planet has got two ways of life, he said. Two kinds of lifestyles are there for people to live, which they are not aware of. So now I'll tell you, the two kinds of lives are, number one is Shreyo life and second one is Shreyo life. Shreyaha and Preyaha, both kinds of lifestyles are there for everyone to choose and live. Or to choose both or whatever they do with that kinds of lifestyles. So what are these two kinds of lives? That is the topic of today's lesson. My dear friends, kindly listen to the lifestyle procedures and effect of lifestyles and the methodology of that lifestyle. One, we will first deal with Preyaha Jivana. Preyo Jivana. Preyo Jivana, where it is a Sanskrit term. If we divide it, it becomes Preyaha less Jivana. So in Telugu, Prayasu, we call, you see. In Prayas is called, even Hindi also. Prayas, Shreyas. Shreyas Karamaina 20, the Telugu. Prayo Jivanamu, Anir Endavati. So, Prayas is the kind of life. How it will be, I'll tell you. This Prayo Jivana, in English, the meaning, Preyaha means very, very attractive, likable, okay, choicy, choosy, selective, visible, external, objective, non-spiritual, okay, and then Preyaha, that means very dear one, very dear. In Telugu, but in Sanskrit also, there is another word which you may understand the exact meaning of that. From Preyaha, the word Preyasi has come. You understand? Preyasi means a dear one, dear most, okay? Lovely, we can say, okay? These are the meanings attributed to the word Preyo Jivana. So our life entirely is dependent and founded on these kinds of values. Whatever attractive, we go for that. Whatever is looking fine, we go for that. Whatever is tasteful, we go for that. Whatever is available to hand, we just encroach upon that. Whatever something is like that, you know, all wantings and desires and everything will be there. So non-spiritual, they never understand the spiritual science. These kind of people always either be rajasic or tamasic. Rajasic means activity oriented, tamasic means body and self oriented. Not self, self means selfish things only. That is for food. That's it. Food. Roti, kapda aur makan. This is the target for them. Roti, kapda aur makan. For self and their own people. These are the tamasika, ignorant people. Ignorant of the higher consciousness. Ignorant of only limited. Ignorant of spiritual science. And rajasic people also come under this category. They also do some sort of great works, but with self motive. The motive for them is only personal gains, personal benefits. They also donate heavily, but only to get fame, name. They go even to the temple and donate heavily. Even at the temple also, he will ask only personal desires. Oh Lord, you make me successful in this venture, in this contract. You kindly see that I get contract. You see that I get benefit in this transaction. You give me victory. You give me success. Always asking for personal gains. Rajasi. Activities are there. They also help others. They also everything they do. Still, the motivation behind that is only personal gain. That will not work. So that is coming under Rayo life. Dearer to him is fame and name, not the good of the society. Not the good of your own self-development. You don't improve your wise wisdom. You go after external things. They go after money and matter.
Sorry to interrupt you, sir. Are you sharing any screen? Are you sharing any screen, sir?
No screen. No screen is there.
No screen. Okay. Thank you.
So did not get opened up. No, there is some sort of technical lag is there. So this PPT is not coming up. Okay. I will share it to you tomorrow day after. Okay. So this kind of life behind money and matter, possessive nature, I want that, I want that. Everything, whatever they do is only for the name and fame and personal gains. These people are called living prayo life. These people are behind only a sort of temporary pleasures, temporary peace, temporary comforts. When once they have great attachment to the physical objects, they have great attachment to the kith and kin. They are always attached to something or the other. When once they lose that, they are subjected to heavy loss, subjected to heavy troubles. A lot of sorrowful life will be there for them. The people have mixed life, that sorrow and happiness will be equally, or more sorrow and less good times for them. So the life is confused and turbulent. They will not be happy. They are engaged throughout the life without enjoying the life they spend. They always go after money. They always go after something, 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 which is not truth. illusory word. Illusory means whatever available, they are not able to see. They mistake it for nothing. And whatever is untrue and not good, they mistake it for all the good and they go for that. And they get headache and they fall in a pit and they face sorrow. And they will curse the God for that. See, the God is there for removing them, the troubles they feel. That is not correct. Whatever you do, you will get it. So this is the way of opposite life. So this sort of prayer life, this man will be meeting only sorrowful life. They never try to understand themselves. They never try to go for truth. Honesty is far away for them. Truth is never thought of. Welfare of the society is next to their personal gains. They will never bother about others. So this kind of life will give them sorrowful life, and that is, they get no liberation from sorrow at any cost. Dukkha rahitya will not be there for them, number one. Number two, they will be stuck up in the cycle of birth and death. Always they keep rotating. They take birth, they die, again they take birth, again they die. So this is the people get stuck up with life and birth and death, and they will not be escaping rebirth. They will not escape sorrowful life, and they cannot escape rebirths also. So, my dear friend, this is the kind of life what majority of the current society is leading. You ask anyone, they say that we are not happy. They say they have umpty number of issues and problems, obstacles, so much they will say. Half an hour happy, the day long unhappy. This is the kind of life that is only Prayojivana. It comes under Prayojivana, which is explained in Kathopanishad. People have this kind of life. So they advise, kindly give up that and go on towards another kind of life. What is that? So now we will deal with what is the Sreyo life, Sreyo Jivana. Sreyas. Meaning of Sreyas, my dear friends, Shreyaskara. Shreyaha means preferable in Sanskrit. Shreyaha means which is preferred to in English. Progressive. Unnati in sense, progress, okay. Sreyas karasiddhihi. What is dharma? Yataha nisreyas karasiddhis tato dharma iti uchyate. That is the Nirukta says in Mahavedas. Nisreyas karasiddhihi, sreyas karasiddhihi, nisreyas karasiddhihi. That means every kind of good nisreyas kara. Siddhihi. That means fulfill. That means get a hold of that which happens to us. Unnati is to happen. By dint of any action, if we get progress, that action is called dharma. So, better phrase, Sreyo life, Sreyo Jivana is equal to dharma palana. Sreyo Jivana is equal to life of dharmic values. So this kind of people will always go with dharma. Ahimsa paramo dharma. So my dear friends, we must follow non-violence. We should never be violent in any kind of action with self and others. Personally, you should not be violent. You can never say that I am not okay, or I should be punished, or I should suicide myself. All these things are prayojivana. Violent life is prayojivana. You should never be tough for you also. You have done a mistake, doesn't matter. What is to be done is to rectify that, not to repent. My dear friends, in Sanskrit there is a word, paschattapa. Many of the people think that paschattapa means repentance. Repentance means you should feel sorrow or sorry for whatever you have done. But the meaning of paschattapa is not that. So what to do? They are unnecessarily mistaking and going towards wrong thing. For every small thing, people will comment on that fellow's, you know, he is not repenting also. Having done a mistake, he is never feeling sorry for that. He need not feel sorry. No one need feel sorry for anything. Whatever, even if they do mistake also, no feeling sorry. What is that you have to do? You have to do paschattapa. What is that? Tapasya paschat. Whatever action, whatever happened, mistake took place, after that what is supposed to be done? You have to rectify that. You have to correct that and go forward. You cannot stop. Because of the mistake, you should not stop. You should continue rectifying the previous action in a right way. That leads to your progress. Not for feeling sorrow or sorry, crying, weeping, all those things will not give you a forward step. It will not give you progress. On the other hand, it will take away your time. On the other hand, you will be delayed in all your work, or you will be unnecessarily wasting time. That will give you a regress, not progress. So, my dear friends, Shreya life is always walking forward. So, that kind of life, goal-oriented life, Shreya Jivana is self-development, not body development. Not personal gains, but this is universal gains. Shreya life will always look after universal gains. That is self-development, atmonnati. You will think always to develop your own self. Self means knowledge, the wisdom, your own personality you should develop. Higher consciousness, the mind should be elevated to the higher consciousness. That is called self-development. Going for higher goals in the life, set up a goal in your life. I want to become a big industrialist, I want to become a big scientist, I want to become in the current times, you know, we should go for the administration purposes, administrative cadres, IAS, ICS. We should go for the welfare of the people, become an educationist, not seeking a job of clerk or assistant or thus, that way, this way and all those. They are all there, of course, but your aim should be, which is useful. You will be useful to the majority of the people if you go on the higher level. If you are on the average level, you will be useful only to your family, yourself. Or if you are not even below average, if you are only below average, you will neither be useful to you and anybody. So, my dear friends, you should always aim above average, so that you will be able to reach the majority of the society to help. You will yourself, it will be helpful to you and others also. When you are in a position to help others, definitely you can help yourself. Automatically, it goes without saying. That is the way of setting a goal for us and proceeding with that self-development. This is the kind of life called Shreya Jivana. And that will bring Shreyas to all others. You will take care of many, many families when you reach above average in the lifestyle. And then ethical ways he will follow. he will realize, he will be more spiritual. All his actions will be according to dharmic values. By yogic ways, he will follow. Everything will be ethical. No hurting others. No violence on others. No shouting. No complaint. No copying. No judging. No complaint. No anxiety. No depressions. No anger. No jealousy. No Arishat Vargas at all. No Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Moha, Madha, Mascharyas are all dissolved. The man is full of ocean. Oceanic knowledge. And he will be non-perturbed. Na dveshti. Na hrushyasi. Na hrushyati, na dveshti. Na kanshati. He will not ask anything. Nor he will be jealous of others. Nor he will be overjoyous. Na dveshti, na vrushyati, na kanshati, sachame bhakta priyaha. Sarva aramba parityagi. All renunciations, he will be the order of the life. The people in Sreya life are habituated to renunciation. No attachment with anything. But he will be with them. But no attachment. It is not that rejection. They will not reject the people. They will accept everyone. At the same time, no attachment. They will take care of everyone. At the same time, there is no attachment. I love my people, but I exist in the absence of them also. That is the policy of Sreya's life. I take care of everyone. Everyone is equal to me. So equanimity is the characteristic of Sreya life. Love, light and power are their major qualities. Love means no hating others. Always be friendly with everyone. They will be friends of whole globe. They will be kind to everyone, including animals. Not only humans. All species they love, they will be friendly, kind, compassionate. And they will be highly wise enough to help any sort of issues, any sort of problems. These as well as others. And they find the God in every person. They understand that we are the gods and everyone is the same. Everyone has the potential of Godhood. Everyone is God. All are having Godhoods. So we are all equal. Law of oneness. So they will be aware of all these essential truths. They are truthful. And they will be able to lead a happy life and make others live happily. This is the kind of Sreya Jivana. But now we have heard both kinds of life. Sreya Jivana and Sreya Jivana is fine. But we have only one life. How? We don't have two lives. So only one life, we have to see both kinds of lives. You must be external as well as internal. Isavasya Upanishad in our Vedas clearly outlines that man has to know both. So you must be externally, you must have internally aware. So externally means you have to enjoy the world because you have come here. You cannot refuse the people. You are among them. You have to. But no attachment. So you have to mix Sreya life with the Sreya life. So far as the violence is concerned, you should remove that. You should deal with the external life with the principles of Sreya life. You have to do everything in the physical life with the background of Sreya principles. With the background of spiritual science, you have to lead your physical life. You have to enjoy everything here. Should not leave anything here without experiencing. You have to experience. While experiencing, you follow the Sreya principles. The principles of spiritual science will give you sorrow, and you will be escaping rebirth. So, my dear friend, have you understood? On the line? Hello? Hello?
Hello,
sir.
Yes, sir. Winter, sir? Ah, okay. Ah, in the country, some call. People will be trying to call, you know. Okay, now, anyway, you are able to see my image? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Are you able to see my image?
Yes, sir.
No?
Yes.
Okay, okay, fine. You are listening to me. Okay. So now, Sreya life is a materialistic life. Sreya life is a spiritual life. Self-development and universal development we take care of. And Sreya life is only self-centered and materialistic life without a sort of a feeling of honesty, a feeling of friendship, feeling of love. Love, light and power we have to apply. That's it. It is not here to not to do anything in a materialistic life. Money and matter are equally usable for the Sreya life. You have to use this materialistic, everything, whatever available. Isa Varsha Vidagam Sarvam. The whole thing is filled up with Ishvara. Whatever you see on this materialistic life, in this world, in this earth planet, whatever is moving on, whatever is not moving, whatever available, everything is filled up with Ishvara, okay? And everything, whatever available in this earth planet is for your enjoyment. Understand? So if you are not enjoying this, if you are not enjoying the fruit, the whole nature weeps. If you are not enjoying anything, whatever available here, if you don't enjoy, the nature feels sorry, okay? So you are here only to enjoy thing and experiencing. But one condition is there. Whenever you are enjoying the nature, say take bathing in the rivers, go anywhere else for everything, enjoying the atmosphere, enjoying the total nature, all sorts of miraculous things available in this nature. Everything you have to experience with one condition. What is that condition? You should not feel that you are the owner of that. You should not feel to possess that. Don't think that you can take it into your hand and go away and claim authority over that. You cannot be owner of anything here. Tena chaktena bhunjita. So that is the dictum from Ishavasya Upanishad. A wonderful principle laid down for your happy life. If you are not following this, if you overcome this, or if you give up this principle, then you are landing yourself into hectic sorrow life. Tena chaktena bhunjita. Very, very clearly underlined, you know. You don't claim ownership here for anything, whatever available on this earth planet. You come here without anything, go back without anything. You remember that. If you want to carry something, then you cannot. You are in sorrow. That is why, you know, people are finding everything in sorrowful, because they want to possess that. They want to capture that. They want to dominate on that. They want to control that. Then they are landing themselves in problems. So you enjoy everything in this life. The Sravaya life is only enjoyment of everything with a dharmic ways. So, my dear masters, Sraya and Praya life, both are necessary, but only thing is that spiritual science should be added to that. The food, whatever we are taking, physical food, is always okay, but add some heat to that. Some taste, always you should add. The taste is called Sraya Jivana. Okay. So, always you apply some sort of spiritual science, apply some sort of, a sort of nobility to the action, whatever you do. Noble actions, turn nobility. So, that requires an amount of wisdom for that. What is that wisdom? Spiritual wisdom. So, my dear friends, to acquire spiritual wisdom, there is only one methodology, that is called meditation. This is what our ancestors have already made it very clear to us, that you will be having wonderful Sraya life by means of spiritual science. Do meditation, get hold of the spiritual wisdom, and enjoy the earth planet with all kinds of experiments, experiences, joy and happiness, without violence and without claiming ownership. Then you will escape not only sorrow, you will escape rebirth also. Once you understand that you are the God and you are the soul and not the body, that's how your life is led, then you are there sure to escape rebirth. Okay. So two in one goal. What is that? Do meditation and realize yourself. You will be escaping sorrow. You will be escaping rebirth. And you will be catching hold of happy life. And you will save everybody. You will get fame, name, money, matter, everything with that. Unasked you will get. So this Sraya life is the one which fetches you everything, whatever you want. So that you will escape the rebirth also. So this is how Lord Yama has answered Mr. Nachiketa. Without telling the secret of death, he has revealed that if you do like this, you will escape that. You understand? Otherwise, you will not escape. This is the essence of Ghatopanishad, and this is the essence of today's lesson. So, my dear friends, kindly understand and take something out of this so that we will implement and get the benefit of the grape science. Okay? So, thank you very much. We will conclude this session for today. And Srikanji, kindly take us for me. అండ్ చేయవలసింది చేయవటమే కర్తవ్యం. మీరు చేయాల్సింది చేయాలి. ఇప్పుడు హింస లేకుండా ఉండాలి అని అంటే మీరు చేయవలసిన పని చేస్తేనే హింస లేకుండా ఉంటుంది సార్. మీరు చేయవలసిన పని చేయలేదనుకోండి, ఎవరికో ఎవరికి హింస అవుతుంది. అది ఖచ్చితంగా అవుతుందా రాదా, అవుతుందా కాదా చెప్పండి. ఇప్పుడు మీరు క్లాసుకు కానీ ఎవరో ఒక రూపాయి క్లాసుకు రాలేదనుకోండి, దే విల్ బి అట్ లాస్ కదా. ఆధ్యాత్మికంగా కొన్ని విషయాలు తెలియకపోతే జీవితానికి హింసించినట్టే కదా.
అవును,
తన జీవితాన్నే హింసకు లోను చేస్తున్నాడు కదా. అలాంటిది అనమాట. ఎవరి కర్తవ్యం వాళ్ళు చేస్తూ ఉంటేనే హింస లేకుండా ఉంటుంది. అందుకని హింస లేకుండా ఉండాలి అని అంటే నీ పని నువ్వు చేయాలి అని అర్థం. ఏదైనా సరే హింస లేకుండా ఉండాలి అని అంటే సవ్యంగా ఉండాలి. మీరు మీరు అపసవ్యంగా మీరు ఉన్నారంటే ఎవరికో ఎవరికి దానివల్ల బాధ అవుతుంది చూడండి. కాబట్టి హింస అనేది జీవితం అంతా కూడా కూడుకున్నది హింస. మీరు మీ ఇంట్లో సరిగా మాట్లాడలేదు అంటే చాలా మంది బాధపడతారు, అది హింస కాదా? కాబట్టి మీరు మంచివారు ఎలా అవుతారు చెప్పండి. అందుకని మంచి అని అంటే నో హింస ఎవరికి, అంటే మీ పని మీరు సక్రమంగా చేయాలి, ఆటోమేటిక్ అది. కాబట్టి ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఈస్ కవర్డ్ అండర్ నాన్ వైలెన్స్. యూ మస్ట్ బి పక్కా జెంటిల్మన్ టు అవాయిడ్ వైలెన్స్. అప్పుడు మిమ్మల్ని మీరు తిట్టుకుంటే కూడా మీరు మంచివారు కాదని అర్థం, ఎందుకంటే హింస చేస్తున్నారు మీకే, మీ తల మీరే తిన్నట్టు లెక్క.
అలాగే
మీ తల మీరు కూడా తినరాదు, తినరాదు అంటే మీరు తిట్టుకోకూడదు మిమ్మల్ని ఎవరైనా సరే. ఆత్మనింద మహాపాపం అవునా కాదా?
అవును.
అంతే, హింసిస్తున్నారు కాబట్టి మహాపాపం. ఎవరిని హింసిస్తున్నారు? మీ మనస్సును మీరే హింసిస్తున్నారు. ఆత్మనిందా మహాపాపం, పరనింద మహాపాపం, పరులను కూడా చేయి. అర్థమైంది? పరను బయదొడస్టు మహాపాపం ఉంటూ కన్నడలో చెప్తారు. పరను బయదొడస్టు, పరను పరను వల్ల పరమాత్మ నాగువా అని చెప్తాడు. వేరే వాళ్ళు ఎవరో వేరు కాదునైనా వాళ్ళంతా పరమాత్మలు అని చెప్తారు. ఓకే, సో ఏ కవి చూసినా, ఏ మహామనిషిని అడిగినా కూడా, ఏ గ్రంథాలు చూసినా కూడా మనకి ఒకటే ఒక మెసేజ్ ఏంటంటే, ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఇస్ ఫిల్డ్ అప్ విత్ గాడ్ అండ్ బి ఆల్వేస్ ఆల్వేస్ బి గుడ్. గుడ్ మీన్స్ షన్ వయలెన్స్. అంతే అంతే, ఎవరికి కష్టం కలిగించరాదు. డోంట్ హర్ట్ ఎనీవన్.
అలాగే
దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ గుడ్ పర్సన్. ఓకే సార్.
సార్ పుస్తకాలు మనం చదువుకోవడానికి మనకి రిఫరెన్స్ పుస్తకాలు టైటిల్స్ అలాగా మనకి ఎక్కడన్నా దొరుకుతాయా సార్?
ఏ పుస్తకాలు చదవాలి? ఏదైనా
ఈ సైంటిఫిక్ స్పిరిచువాలిటీ గురించి చదివేదానికి.
ఓకే, సో మీరు ఏం చేయాలని అంటే, ఇప్పుడు ఐ హ్యావ్ గాట్ వన్ లిటరేచర్, మాకు మేము క్లాసులకి వచ్చిన వాళ్ళకి అందరికీ నేను మేము ఇస్తూ ఉంటాము. అందులో ఏమి చేయాలి, ఏ పుస్తకాలు చదవాలి అంతా కూడా లిస్టు వేసి ఇచ్చాం. ఇప్పుడు కూడా ఇస్తున్నాం మేము. 3 డేస్ కోర్స్ అంతా కండక్ట్ చేస్తాం కదా, పిఎస్ఎస్సి అకాడమీ వాళ్ళు చేస్తారు కదా, అందులో ఈ పుస్తకాలతో పాటు ఈ పుస్తకం కూడా ఇస్తాం అన్నమాట. అందులో డైరెక్షన్స్ ఉంటాయి, తర్వాత పుస్తకాల లిస్టు కూడా ఉంటుంది. అందులో ఆ లిస్టు తీసుకొని మీరు ఒక్కొక్కటి మీరు ఒకసారి టచ్ చేసుకుంటూ పోవచ్చు, చూసుకుంటూ పోవచ్చు. ప్రతి ఒక్కరు కూడా ఇంట్లో ఒక లైబ్రరీ పెట్టుకోవాలి. లాట్ ఆఫ్ కొన్ని పుస్తకాలు ఇంట్లో ఉంటే అవి మీకు రిమైండ్ చేస్తూ ఉంటాయి కనీసం. ఇప్పుడు పుస్తకాలు రాసేవాళ్ళు ఎందుకు రాస్తారు చెప్పండి? ఎవరెవరు చదువుతారనే రాస్తారు, కానీ మనం చదవకపోతే అది వేస్ట్ అవుతుంది. అన్నీ కూడా వాళ్ళ ఎక్స్పీరియన్సెస్ అనమాట. ఒక హిమాలయన్ యోగీస్ అని ఒక పుస్తకం తీసుకొచ్చాడు స్వామి రామ. మరి అంత మంచి పుస్తకం చదవకపోతే ఎట్లాగా? ఆయన ఎన్నో మంచి మంచి మనకి అహింసాయుతంగా జీవనానికి కావలసిన రహస్యాలని చెప్పాడు ఆయన. చక్కగా ఉంది. అట్లాగే మరి భగవద్గీత చదవాలి, అష్టావక్ర గీత చదవాలి. ఓకే, మరి వివేక చూడమణి అని చదవాలి. ఓకే, తర్వాత మన ఈ ఒక ఉపనిషత్తుల్లో ముఖ్యంగా ఈశావాస ఉపనిషత్తు తెలుసుకోవాలి, భజగోవిందని చదవాలి. ఇవన్నీ ఉన్నాయి పుస్తకాలు. ప్రతిసారు ఎన్నో విషయాలలో అతను చెప్తూ ఉంటారు. కాబట్టి పిరమిడ్ మాస్టర్స్ రియలీ దే ఆర్ వెరీ ఫార్చునేట్. ఓకే, సో వీ హ్యావ్ దిస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంట్రొడక్షన్. కాబట్టి మీరు పెంచుకోవాలి దీన్ని. సో మీరు ఆ పేపర్ ఒకసారి మీ టెలిఫోన్ నంబరు నాకు మెయిల్లో ఇవ్వండి, ఐ విల్ సెండ్ దట్ డాక్యుమెంట్ త్రూ మెయిల్.
ఓకే సార్.
that I will help you. The list of books which we should go through. Okay. Srikanth Garu.
Yes, sir.
I will send that paper having the details of all the books to you. So you can part with everyone. Okay, sir?
Okay, I will share with all.
Share it, everybody. Okay. Okay. So, inka Kondareddy garu unnara?
Kondareddy garu call drop in, sir.
Call drop in, da? Okay, okay. Tarvata inka evaru unnaru? Madam Lakshmi garu unnara? Lakshmi garu unnara?
Lakshmi garu.
లక్ష్మి మేడం గారు.
ఎస్ సార్. ఎస్ సార్.
ఎలాగమ్మా, ఎలాగా ఉన్నది క్లాసెస్? బాగున్నాయా?
బాగున్నాయి సార్.
ఉపయోగానికి రావాలి, మనం ఆచరించడానికి వీలుగా ఉండాలి, అర్థం కావాలి. ఓకే ఓకే. సో మీరు కూడాను కొన్ని పుస్తకాలు అనేది ఒక చూస్తూ ఉండాలి.